Okay, data creation. We're going to talk about data creation in the aggregated world. That means data set, data values, periods, or units. So, okay, first of all, we have two repositories for the aggregated world in the SDK. One of them is the data value module, is the data value repository, and the other is the data set complete registration repository. And both of them are in the data value module. The dataset complete registration, as his name tells, it is for complete the datasets. When you want to complete a dataset that you have just filled up, you can just use this module to do that. So we have also a brief helper that is very handy for aggregated. And you have it in the period module, you have brief helper, and you can use it to get some periods for the different data sets. For example, by using this method, you can pass the dataset UID and you will have a list of periods. And then you can come to the list and get the period one, and you can access to the period ID inside the period object. You have also other methods here in the period helper, so you can explore. And this is like pretty handy because you can avoid malform or wrong periods, a period that doesn't exist in the SDK. And you are sure that all the periods are created in the period table because you have to link it, and they have some foreign keys pointing to the period. And if they don't exist, you can have some errors in your application. And also it will help you picking periods for future that are not defined. And also it will not, so it will help you to those that are not in the details. Data values. For data values, we have this object repository. It's not a collection repository this time, where you can access to all the values. It's an object repository for only one value. In this case, you can access it for the data value module, go to the data values repository, which is a collection repository. But then when you enter dot value, you are asking for the object repository. So for the repository of just the value that makes the combination of period or unit, data element, category option, and attribute options combo. So all of you know that in the aggregated value, a value is defined by those parameters. So to get this repository, you have just to pass them. This repository has a set method that can be used to set the value. For example, if the value is a number, you can put here a 5, or, well, it takes only strings, but you can pass the 5 as a string here. Also, you have the reactive way with the set method, but you also have the blocking way with the blocking set method. If you are confused with the blocking and the reactive way, you can go to the first session of the first workshop we have, and we have it in YouTube. You can review all of that there. So what do we have in the data value of the repository? We have this set value that we just talked about. We have the follow-up, which inserts a value to follow up in the database. We have a comment, and you can use the get to return the object, exist to know if the object exists, if it has been created before. The delete, which will try to delete the object, but if it doesn't exist, it will throw a DHIS2 error. For that reason, do you have also the delete if exists that allows you to use it, delete without using first the exist method to know if the value exists in the database. And for the dataset complete registrations, we have a thing like it's quite the same of the data values. So to access this, to access the repository, you can go to dataset complete registration inside the dataset module. And because if it is defined by the period or unit dataset and attribute option combo, you can go through the method value. We also have here the block insert method to insert the complete registration. Also, in the same way, you have the get, the exist, the delete, and the delete of exist in the repository too. And now we're gonna go to the exercises.